know I'm a vibe and I run as usual. I didn't only come around just to make it.
You know I never did you wrong. Even though I'm right here by the phone, dog.
I knew a Kanye West Donda Deluxe was going to come, but I didn't think it would be this soon. I really thought that we were probably going to wait until, you know, late December, early January, February to probably hear it. But Kanye's impulsive. He said he was going to do something, and now all of a sudden he's just following up and doing the things that he said he's going to do and not lying to his audience for once. I'm very proud. Probably all that post-nut clarity from watching all those OnlyFans videos on Reddit, but I don't really know. All I do know is Donda would be very, very proud. And to have a deluxe addition to an album that was already great to me to begin with is a great thing. One of these tracks, I think I've already heard, one called Life of the Party with Andre. Now, people have told me not to listen to the album version because the other version, I don't remember the reason. The single version, I think, is better than the album version. Another one people have been adding me about is No Family Something. Family Something. Always Keep the Family Something. I don't remember if I heard Up from the Ashes. I don't remember that being a part of the original. Yeah, okay, so I'm not crazy. I'm not disabled. Wasn't the original one like 27 tracks? How are there 5 new tracks and then and there's only 3 new songs? I'm so... Oh! Maybe Remote Control is going to be better this time. How do I listen to the single version of Life of the... See, Kanye fans make shit so difficult. They're just like him and then they act so superior when this nigga don't drop on time. Asking me to listen to the single version. The single version isn't available on streaming. The fuck are you talking about? And watch it be the one I already heard. Hold up, Brent Faiyaz has a new album coming out.
You, baby.
Why wasn't Brent Faiyaz on the Donda album? That makes no sense. Kanye not really tapped in. All right, I'm sorry, but I'm gonna have to listen to the album version because, like, this doesn't make sense.
Life of the party.
I said, say something. I'm starting to believe ain't no such thing as heaven's trumpets. No, after over, this is it.
I'm like questioning everything you know and love because of the loss of, you know, your most loved one. And this lack of communication and connection you felt to them over the years has gotten you to question, like, your own faith, you know, your own religious walk. And then doing so and being so, like, I don't know, like, emotionally and spiritually vulnerable on a song with someone else who's also known the pain and experienced losing their mother. I don't know. That was just such an incredibly sensitive moment for Andre to reveal. And I appreciate it. Everybody being let in on that.
If God knew that I would be trouble, keeps me around for what I don't know, but I do know that it's crucial that we
go in big. What?
Oh, I like that. I have no idea why Kanye didn't just have Life of the Party on the original version. It would have been such a great addition to an already really great album. I don't know why he left it off. The next one in the deluxe, I think, that I haven't heard is Up from the Ashes.
Tell me.
Oh my God! Yeah. Oh my! Who is on the strings right now? It's great because Kanye makes sample music. Kanye makes that music that you want to chop and just like put into every other record. It's perfect backdrop music. He's capturing a church-like aesthetic. And you got the choir swelling up. Oh. You know, one thing I will always respect about gospel music is like its consistency. Like, it very rarely strays away from trying its best to be uplifting, despite how oftentimes, I guess, not really nuanced it can be in like the faith walk. Sometimes it's just Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And I appreciate, like, you know, that Kanye is bringing forth a real life experience and bringing forth his own struggles and his own pain. And Up from the Ashes is almost like this acknowledgement of a ruined previous life or a life left behind. Him just kind of realizing, at least in his perspective, his previous life being inferior to the one that he's embracing right now. And the choir in the back, you know, it's always like angels just uplifting whatever message you're already trying to push. People been going crazy about Never Abandon Your Family. That's what it's called. So I'm gonna listen to that one and then we'll probably listen to these part twos. And I guess that's it for the deluxe, but I mean, I still think these tracks are good for it.
Never abandon your family.
Is that like a shot to Kanye? I mean, a shot to Kim. But a bit of me still, like, I still remember, like, piece of his Drink Champs interview, he's going off about like, oh, you know, I still want to keep my family together. I don't know if that's what he thinks. I don't know if he thinks that Kim is like abandoning him by saying, if you get a, if you divorce me. I think it's a little misguided, but like, if that's what that is, then I see the connection.
Darkness can't take life from me. Haven't you gone far enough? Leave up on your sanity.
The way he's coming in vocally is hard to predict.
My family,
this is blues right here. His guitar in the back is really like a cry. It's like a lingering cry in the background, like a plea for help, like please save me. Like it's that, it just adds such emotion and color and passion to the track. Outside of Kanye already singing well, because I don't think he does that often, but he sing, when he sings well, he sings really, really well.
Come back tonight, daddy, please. Come back tonight, daddy, daddy.
This is crazy. So I don't know if that's referring to his own father, or maybe, I don't know if he's speaking from like the perspective of one of his own kids. I don't know. But that is a very, very heartfelt track. Very, very emotional. Lots of passion that you could feel. That guitar adds so much emotion and color as well. Yeah, that was great. It does finish like I was looking for that climax in that track, though. I was like, that climax in that track would have been awesome. I don't know if they would have just, I mean, adding drums just adds this kind of fake cinematic feel to it that I feel like it might not need, but like maybe violins or something, just like to, I don't know, the guitar was great, but I feel like after listening to it, like that's it. Like, I want it to be a little more instrumentally, but it's still great the way it is. I just want something else. I don't know what I want, but I want another thing. Why is No Child Left Behind on track number 10 now? And why is Hurricane number 2? Why is Moon... Why is it sequenced like this?
Watch him go, baby, like what she see. Hey, we riding. It's a little bit of looking, I'm sliding.
Oh man, I didn't know I needed Cudi on remote control. Hold on. Oh yeah. They should have just gave Cudi remote control. I didn't need Young Thug or Kanye on that track, to be honest. And the whistles, the whistles is what really made this track annoying for me. But Cudi, just like in this space, you know, kind of secluded like that, I like it. That was a good track. I think the only other thing is that Tyler, the Creator, has background vocals on Come to Life. And I don't really think I need to listen to a whole track just to hear his background vocals. But we will listen to it, but at a later time. You know, it was only 4 tracks. I'm used to deluxe records being a lot more juicy as far as like what they add to the original record. Or at least that's what I've been used to over the past couple of years, as artists have literally just added additional albums to pre-existing albums and then labeled them or marketed them as deluxes. I like that in this, we actually just have slight additions to the album. There wasn't a whole marketing run for the deluxe. There wasn't like this huge rollout for a deluxe just to add a couple of songs, 5 additional songs to an album that was already 27 tracks. This is how I feel like deluxes should be done. You just slowly add more to an album that you feel like wasn't complete or could have used your other work. I don't feel like it needs a press release because you want to drop another album under the guise of the same fucking album you dropped the previous week. So I appreciate that this hasn't been like this overblown press release. Oh, I got another album coming out. Like, nah, man, just put your extra shit on the album and let it speak for itself. I like that. The tracks that were added here, I like, you know, the Andre 3000 one, obviously. That being added to this album steps it up even more. No Family or Don't Leave Your Family Behind. I forgot what it was called already again. That was another great track. I think if they would have just replaced the Kid Cudi replaced the Young Thug and Kanye version with the Kid Cudi version of Remote Control, I think that would have been perfect as well. But anything that was added to this record, I feel like has just made it better. I don't feel like anything that's been added has bogged it down. So thumbs up for Kanye. I think this was a successful deluxe. There are enough added tracks to just add to Donda as an album as opposed to take attention away from the original body of work. So you make an already great album even greater, and it's all smiles from everyone on all sides, at least in my opinion. These extra songs have been great. I got another video coming about this Donda album, though, about how I feel about it, like, months later. I really do think it's one of Kanye's best in, like, a minute. So, yeah, y'all let me know how you feel about it in the comment section down below, and I'll see you in the next one. I'm out. Jesus loves you.